staying tuned to your station, the Africa Independent Television, and welcome to your program, Security Watch Africa. Only on this channel, we'll bring you information you need to live to keep your life safe and secure. Wherever you're watching us, I say welcome. My name still remains Patrick Abambo. Today, it's actually a wonderful day, and we'll just go straight to show you some of the things that Security Watch Africa covered during the week. We went back to the Southern Kaduna axis of Nigeria to monitor what happened or what's happening after our last visit. And we are to report to you that contrary to media report, everything is calm and there was no such killing as was being reported in the media. We'll get you that report later on. You hear the people, the stakeholders talk to us about what is happening in Kaduna, Southern Kaduna precisely. Then as part of the reward system which the Nigerian police have just introduced on promoting those officers who have one way or the other done exceptional. Some officers were recently promoted and they were decorated at the first headquarters, and among those who got these, leading those were, most of them were previous Security Watch Africa Awards winners. I'm talking about CP Ahmed Bello Ahmed, talking about CP Hafiz Inua, talking about ACP Abakiari, and some other people. We'll get you that report. I don't need to unveil it for you to, you need to hear it. Then we'll also let you know what is happening in the whole of Kaduna, because the Commissioner of Police is still with us, though we had a chat with him to tell us what is happening in Kaduna. Stay tuned as we bring you the report of the decoration of some police officers at the first headquarters in Abuja.
Officers, friends and family members of the newly promoted police officers gathered at the force headquarters to witness their decoration by the Inspector General of Police, Ibrahim Idris. The officers who were promoted to the acting capacity of their next rank were four commissioners of police, one deputy commissioner of police, three assistant commissioners of police, and one superintendent of police. Leading the pack is the acting commissioner of police in charge of the police mobile force, CP Bello Ahmed, followed by the force public relations officer, CP Don Awuna, the principal staff officer to the inspector general of police, CP Hafiz Inua, and the acting commissioner of police in charge of the IGP monitoring unit, CP Garuba Umar. Others also decorated include DCP Abu Sani, the officer in charge of the IGP intelligence response team, ACP Abba Kiari, and the personal assistant to the IGP, SP Abdul Abdul. The Inspector General of Police was assisted in decorating the officers with their new ranks by members of the police management team and family members. IGP Idris, in his remarks after the decoration, congratulated the officers and charged them to redouble their efforts in their service to Nigeria.
To honor officers who have distinguished themselves in their various capacities and exhibited spectacular performance in discharge of their duties. This brief ceremony this morning is management's recognition of some officers who have ennobled themselves through hint of hard work, dedication to duty and service to the community. As a deliberate management policy, more of such elevations are in the process of other deserving officers. On behalf of the force management, I congratulate you on your very well-deserved elevation. I implore you to wear your new ranks with deep sense of commitment to duty, responsibility, and humility. It goes without saying that to whom much is given, much is expected. You must see your elevations within the context of a springboard to greater challenges and increased efforts to accomplish organizational goals. At this juncture, I therefore direct departmental heads, zonal and state commands formations, units to reactivate the reward system within their powers to adequately reward deserving officers, police officers.
Some of the officers spoke to Security Watch Africa on how they feel and pledge to work harder.
Elated, fulfilled, accomplished, because that's the pride of every policeman. First of all, I appreciate the Almighty God, my Creator, whom I'm serving. Then I sincerely thank the Inspector General of Police, who find me worthy to recommend me to the Police Service Commission and the President. I most sincerely thank Mr. President, who saw my track record and found it fit to approve my promotion to this president rank. I thank him. I thank all members of Police Service Commission who deliberated, who sat, who went into my record and conveyed the approval to me. As promised before, I am still promising to put in my best into my job for the unity of this country. I've been doing it. I'm a professional policeman. I've been a crisis manager, and I manage crisis. The upcoming officers, let them work hard. Let them work hard and work hard without reservations. Let them work hard, let them work hard. Sky's their limit. All right.
Glory to God, the Almighty God. Then to the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, President Muhammadu Buhari, for finding it worthy in Ibrahim Potum Idris to be selected or to be his chosen Inspector General of Police. And thirdly, Inspector General himself, who find it worthy to choose me as his principal staff officer to work with him and to accept me and find me worthy of being elevated to this enviable position. I give glory to the IG. I thank him immensely because staying with him, I have learned quite a lot. I wish to say that having been fulfilled, I am ready to redouble my effort to ensure that I do not only become a good ambassador to the police, but that I will not let my country down by the grace of God. And all what it takes to show professionalism, to be open, democratic, and accessible, as the IG used to teach us, I will be. I'll try to do my very best to the nation.
I'm so happy and proud of myself and my family. I've always, all my life since I joined the force, I've always been workaholic. I dedicate myself, my life to this job, and I give in my best. And throughout my career till date, I've never been found wanting. I've always been given my best. And I think what I've always been given, it is what motivated my IGP or encourages the Police Service Commission to promote me to this rank. My advice to other officers who are willing to join us on this cadre is to be loyal, dedicated, honest, and hardworking.
Appreciation also goes to the Inspector General of Police because of without his recommendation, this thing wouldn't have happened. So I'm very much grateful for him to find me capable, worthy of this promotion, and this will go a long way in boosting my morale, the morale of my men, and to redouble our efforts to do even more to make sure that all these criminal and dangerous elements are brought to book. Also, my special appreciation goes to the President and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces for the Presidential Medal of Courage that was given to me. You know, it's a great honor to be given this kind of rare Medal of Courage by the President of the country. And this has gone a long way in boosting my morale, and this is something that will be celebrated even after your retirement. Because only very few people in the armed forces and police that are given this kind of medal, and it's quite honoring to receive such. Today is a great day for us. My family and everybody were there in the decoration ground. And it's a great achievement. It's a great day.
The wife of one of the newly promoted officers, Hadiza Dodo Bello Ahmed, urged wives of police officers to be patient and prayerful for their husbands.
I feel so happy, accomplished, and very excited.
Okay.
Yeah. Whenever there's problem somewhere, they are the kind of people that were sent to take care of the situation. So I would like to wish them all the best, not only my husband, but all the promoted CPs. They have to assist their husbands, yes, because they are out there doing their job. In the home, you have to assist them in taking care of the family. Yes.
I must say congratulations to the newly appointed officers. Indeed, it's a pride to be promoted, to recognize and be promoted and to be decorated. It was one of the most unprecedented crowd we experienced at the Fawcett Quarters. Really, it was. Joining me in the studio is Shino Phillips, the Security Watch Africa International Assessor, already with me. And Shino Phillips, you were there also at the Fawcett Quarters. What did you take out from what happened?
Well, kudos. We really must commend Mr. President for this one. We commend the IGP and the Police Service Commission. It's quite an encouraging one. Finally, I think that as the IGP said, to whom much is given, much is expected. So they should double up and do this nation proud.
All right. Yeah, we have to quickly go to Kaduna again. First, we'll bring the Commissioner of Police, CP Angole Abe, tell us how Kaduna is, how secure, and what is happening in Kaduna. Stay tuned.
The nature of the environment should have proven to you that Kaduna is very, very safe, except for the last incident that took place in one part of Kaduna State, that is the southern Kaduna. Otherwise, relatively, Kaduna is peaceful. We've been able to bring down the level of crime to a near acceptable standard. And however, there are few instances of this crime perpetrated by these youths in remote part of the town when they are under the influence of drugs and stab themselves during fight. And I think I have come up with a strategy to curb this menace of these young boys. And we have been conducting raids on especially hideouts where these young men hide and take drugs, and we've made considerable recoveries. And I think between that period I took over and now, the rate of the murder cases arising from or induced from drug taking has reduced drastically, but we have not stopped. The case of kidnapping in Kaduna, which used to be an occurrence, I'm glad to tell you that after since my assumption as the Commissioner of Police, Kaduna State, we have one noticeable incident which was on the news of the kidnap of the former ambassador. And I'm also glad to tell you that the ambassador, through our concerted efforts, we've been able to secure his release. And as I'm speaking with you, we just have one or two persons to reach to be able to complete the cycle of the vicious criminals that were involved in not just the kidnap of the ex-ambassador, but also responsible for various high-profile kidnaps in the state. Believe that the issue in Kaduna, especially the recent case, the crisis, is a religious issue at all. And we had the privilege of meeting with the elders of thought. So it's quite unfortunate that because we spoke with, when the IG visited, even the bishop, one Bishop Jato spoke. and he never saw it as a religious issue. The imam has never seen it as a religious issue. I think there are more of ethnopolitical dimension to it. And this crisis is an offshoot of other crises in that particular area. So when we are isolating this present crisis from the existing crisis, we might not be able to get it right. This is not the first time there are crises in that part of the area, and there was no religious correlation to them. How suddenly we believe, if the Fulanis who are becoming like part of this crisis, don't forget, the indigenous Fulanis, whom are seen as settlers, have been in that community. They are also farmers. And don't forget, they also have crops, they have farmlands. And the grazing Fulanis also enter their farmlands. So you find out that I do not see this thing as a religious issue. So I think there are other dimensions to them, because the matter did not start as a religious crisis. It started as a result of some use. Because when we want to get this particular crisis right, we must look at the genesis. What went wrong?
What went wrong, really, it's what will continue with the Commissioner of Police at the next edition of the program, because we really went in deep to find out from the community what went wrong. But let me also, first of all, talk with Shino Phillips to find out from him, interacting with the Commissioner of Police and the state of security in Kaduna. What did you see in Kaduna? But before then, you can communicate with us, you can join us in this on this program by making use of our social media platform. The Twitter account is there, at SecurityWatch97, or send us an email at SecWatchAfrica1997@gmail.com, or like us on our Facebook fan page and send us a comment. Send us what you think about the topic or issues being discussed so that we can take it up with the authorities concerned. Yeah, back to Phil. Yeah, you were with the Commissioner of Police in Kaduna. What did you take out of Kaduna in terms of security?
Well, first, from the Commissioner of Police, he was assuring. I mean, I think it would be wickedness of some sort for him to come out to the public to tell them what does not exist, to tell them there was peace in Kaduna if there was no peace. I mean, we were there, we went around, and we went to all the different villages, the hotspots, and we saw that life, I mean, things were really in order. So for the Commissioner of Police, as we sat with him and saw everything, he needed to assure the public.
And there was passion that when he was talking
about
security.
Yes, he was very passionate about the issue of security in Kaduna. And for him as the man in charge, I mean, it was obvious that they did credibly well, and they also saw to it that there was communal, you know, existence, true life, true living there. I mean, so when they came out to tell Nigerians, when he came out to talk to Nigerians about what is happening in Kaduna, he basically said the truth. Okay. It wasn't what was being described out there.
Okay. Let's hear it from the people in. Some people in Southern Kaduna, not just some people, because these are the heads. First and foremost, we'll bring you our visit to the head of the chiefdom in that area, talking particularly Burunkogi, where we met with the traditional ruler there. He told us what is happening and what he wants to be done. We also met with the district head of Dangoma. He also told us what the situation is like currently there. We also met with all the district head of Goska, who also told us what he thinks should be done for total peace to reign, after which we'll come back and look at the issues arising from that visit. Sit back.
Morning was found, I think he went to the farm or somewhere, was found to have died. That's why the people are disturbed. Otherwise, the presence of security has increased our confidence.
Okay, ordinarily, you people are happy with the police and that are here and everything?
Yes, I would say so.
Okay.
I would say so.
Some people have said a lot of things about the knowing what is causing all the situation here. Some have said it's religious, some are saying it's Fulani people wanted to take over the lands of the native and all that. You are the custodian of the tradition, the culture and the people here. What is actually the problem?
I'm sure you will be in a better position to know, but we are wondering. Wondering because for many ages, even myself, I found my father, maybe my father found his father living together. If it is ordinary grass, you can see plenty of grass here. So I don't know what is causing this. I'm wondering. It used not to be like this. Yes. What I inherited was peaceful coexistence. So that's why I'm saying what is happening now is strange. Strange. Very strange.
And what is the situation now, sir?
Well, in our area, there is no problem. Our problem was only this road. And now our people are moving as normal now.
Oh, correct.
So there is free movement.
Free movement now.
Everywhere now.
Everywhere in
your
our
area now.
Exactly.
So you are moving to Kapanchai.
We are moving to Kapanchai. No.
So as we speak today, Nigerians can be assured that there's peace. In
as far as Dangoma is concerned, yes. Is concerned, we are assuring you this.
And what? How do you assess the police people?
Exactly.
Have they
been very appreciated? Very, very appreciated. I enjoy their service.
So we can tell Nigerians and the entire world that the Nigerian police have done
incredibly well. Yes,
they have done their
best.
And
other security agencies. Exactly.
It's a collective effort.
Yes.
It's a collective effort, all of us.
But you know, the other, you have neighbors. They still have fear. Fears are around that these people may come and attack them. Why do you think they have that fear?
Well, I cannot tell anything about that one because they are suspecting us. While we know that our conscience is clear, we don't have any problem with them. Even before and up to now.
In fact, we told the whole world that you people have been coexisting for about
for
100,
long, exactly,
100 years or more.
Exactly.
500 years.
Over
580. I appreciate their being here.
This situation, this crisis that came up, do you have the hope that it can be resolved?
Really? But let me tell you one thing. 90% of my assurance comes in the sense that if the government determines today this problem will be a thing of the past.
Welcome back. Yeah, like you said, if the government determined today the problem will be a thing of the past. Really, we don't have enough time. We'll have continued with some of other comments that we are being given. The people on the streets of the Southern Kaduna spoke to us because we touched close about eight villages in that area, and we couldn't find where such massive massacre took place or where so many houses were burnt.
In as much as one life is very important,
yes,
but I don't think they should be toiling with this idea of so many lives.
Really, with me, is the document given by the people, talking about the numbers of the people that were killed or those injured, those missing, and all that.
So,
if the people of the Southern Kaduna, the action spot, gave us the document, their own calculation. So I wonder where people are getting the information about the number of people that were killed.
Yeah.
Really, this is the situation.
let me take this.
This is a response from one of our viewers who is commenting through the Twitter account at miss_IEK. He says, "Security was Southern Kaduna killing. This is some amazing revelation. Guys, good job." Yeah, thank you very much. We're having so many coming, but unfortunately, time is not on our side to take all these comments, to take your views. But I'm sure next week we'll collect all these views and read it out so that the world can hear what you're saying. Feel free to send us your view and your comment on this issue. Yeah, you were saying something.
Well, I think that it's very important that as a people, we should all come together, all different religious bodies. I mean, from what all everything we
some
gathered...
Some religious leaders are calling for a lot of things.
I know, so it's sad.
Unfortunately, time is
not enough. God made this country, and with one purpose that will stay as one united entity, and so it will be. You know, it's rather very unfortunate that lies are told out there. And I still implore whoever is in doubt, go there and see
of
for
course,
yourself.
Of course, that's the issue. You don't sit at the comfort of your home and analyze what you think or based on the media report you are getting and say, you need to be there to visit.
Fortunately, we still have more footages.
We have more footages to say. Another comment is coming from Chuk Samuzier. He's saying you have done an in-depth report of Southern Kaduna crisis. It was indeed overflowed. Thank you very much. And there are more footages to actually show you that, contrary to what people said of the news reports, no massacre as it were.
Really. How many of those communities? Goska, Dagoma, Zagun Katap, all the places,
Samaruka,
we
that,
went through all. Yeah. And we are very proud to say that, indeed, this community is safe and Nigerians should go home with the right news.
All right. We must leave for that progress to continue. We'll keep on giving the information, the right information. That is what Security Watch Africa is known for. And when it has to do with security and safety, we'll go every length to bring you that information. You remember, when we bring you the information about what's happening in Northeast earlier, some people never believe, but it turned out to be the truth. So we'll bring you the information that you need to know to keep your life safe and secure. Until we'll come your way again next week. Phil, I know that this week will also be a very busy week,
yes,
trying to unravel or bring the information that the people need. But until next week,
yes,
what do you have to say?
Well, Nigeria is safe, and God bless Nigeria.
All right, thank you very much. Until next week, I would say, remain blessed, and bye for now.